morning, Pirates. Today is Wednesday, October 18th, 2023. I'm Karen Martinez-Vega, and this is your Pirate TV. Karen Martinez-Vega.
Trace calling. Casey White.
Landon Ogre.
Pirates, I'm Karen Martinez-Vega here, and these are the things you need to know. Today, ACE U.S. History Retakes will be taking place in the CIC at 8 a.m. The USF College Visit will be in the CIC at 11 a.m. Basketball cheer tryouts will be held in the cafe at 2:30 p.m. Girls Golf versus Charlotte at the St. Andrews Golf Course at 3:30 p.m. Tomorrow, basketball cheer tryouts will be held in the cafe at 2:30 p.m. Boys Golf versus Lumban Bay at the Lumban Bay Golf Course at 3:30 p.m. And finally, there will be a JV football game versus Charlotte at home at 6 p.m. I'm Karen Martinez-Vega with Pirate TV.
Hey Pirates, as most of you know, the Division Learning has been recruiting local high school juniors and seniors to tutor local elementary schools for a K-3 tutoring program. The available schools for 11th and 12th graders are Neil Armstrong, Peace River Elementary, and Vineland Elementary. So if anyone wants a tutor, there you go.
Pirates, I'm Karen Martinez-Vega here for another edition of This Day in History. On October 18, 1867, the United States officially took possession of Alaska from Russia. This event was first known as Seward's Folly because Seward was the individual who made this purchase. A few months earlier, the U.S. bought the land from Russia for $7.2 million. However, gold was found, therefore making this purchase valuable. A ceremony to commemorate this event was held on the day the U.S. took possession of land at Fort Stika and included 250 troops from the U.S. Army. The Russian soldiers that were present lowered the Russian flag and raised the U.S. flag in its place. It is important to keep in mind that even though the land was purchased, Alaska didn't become a state right away until almost 100 years later in 1959. I'm Karen Martinez-Vega with Pirate TV.
Hello, Pirates. My name is Nathan.
My name is Aiden.
And this is your Big Brain Trivia Challenge.
I'm not a smart man.
Welcome to the Big Brain Challenge. Information guaranteed to blow your mind.
I am the smartest man alive!
The trivia question for today is, what is the original name for candy corn? A. Candy corn. B. Orange triangles. C. Chicken feet. Or D. Corn.
The correct answer is C, chicken feed. The original name for candy corn was chicken feed, which was changed to candy corn in 1898 by a man named Gustav. And that is it for your Big Brain Trivia Challenge.
Hey Pirates, welcome back to another edition of Game Day Live.
Open Chicago with the lead.
Last game day live, we predicted for the Philadelphia Eagles at the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, and this kid over here and I got that prediction right. But now that the second quarter started, we're starting. But at the end of the year, we're going to add up our points and see who wins. Now we're going into the world of basketball, featuring the Sacramento Kings at the Golden State Warriors. Nathan Passwater, who do you have?
Golden State. Because Sacramento Kings, they've been doing some stuff, but nothing too big. You know, Golden State just got Chris Paul, you know, Curry, Clay, you know, Draymond Green, you know, the normal. But, you know, I think Golden State has that chemistry. They always have it. I think they're just going to ball out and win.
Personally, I'm with Nathan on this one. I got Golden State as well. I mean, NBA season just started. Nothing really too serious going on right now, but I think Golden State got this.
Alrighty, so...
Yo, don't be different, bro. Go.
Watch. Alright, so these teams have been against each other previously, and Golden State has won at Sacramento as well. So, yeah, and it was a very close game. But, you know, some of the star players aren't going to be playing since it's the preseason. They don't want to get hurt. But I got to side with the Golden State Warriors. I can't be different here. Yeah, Golden State, they won in their previous matchup at Sacramento. So, yeah, this is going to be at their home arena, and I think they're going to get the win. All right, Golden State, please win. That was your game day live.
Hello, Pirates. I'm Ariana.
And I'm Jaden.
And this is your word of the day. The word of the day is folklore, which is a noun and means the whole of oral tradition shared by a particular group of people, culture, or subculture.
Folklore includes tales, myths, legends, proverbs, poems, and jokes.
Here's folklore in a sentence.
The coyote appears in a great deal of Native American folklore. And that's it for your word of the day.
Hello, guys. Happy spooky season. Your host here is Sabrina Tador, and I'm here with...
Joshua Moreno.
And...
Sebastian Sanchez.
And today, it's a Sabrina Says. Before I start, how's your day?
Pretty good.
I don't care. Anyways, I got a joke. Why did Odell cross the other side?
Why?
To say hello from the other side. That don't make any sense.
It doesn't. But I do like your Halloween costume, though. A for effort.
That's it for today's broadcast. See you next time for some more Pirate TV.
The best news of the seven seas.
Maybe I didn't treat you quite as good as I should have. Maybe I didn't love you quite as often as I could have. Little things I should have said and done, I just never took the time. You were always on my mind.
Always on my mind.
You were always on my mind. Maybe I didn't hold you all those lonely, lonely times. And I guess I never told you I'm so happy that you're mine. If I made you feel second best, girl,